In the normal geometry, a first dimension is the straight line. The third two dimensions are Euclidean plane made with length plus width. The third dimension with three coordinates are 3D of Newton. They are made with length plus width plus depth. Could an object have an intermediary dimension between the second and the third dimensions? MANDELBROT says yes. It is the case of fractals. The more they are broken, the more their fractal dimension increases. The fourth dimension was the work of Albert Einstein. He worked hard to find to the fifth dimension according to the Bible code. In the Bible code, it is written with his name, associated with the theory of relativity, is the following indication given by the Torah code, had a fifth part. Apparently, the answer Albert Einstein sought will not be found in our three spatial dimension, nor in his fourth dimension, but in a fifth dimension, which the specialists of quantum physics now admit that it exists. Most physicists and mathematicians now agree that there is a fifth dimension, but that no one can yet define what it is. The Book of Creation is an ancient religious text written by the patriarch Abraham and cited by Professor Eliyahu Rips, who discovered the Bible code, states that we exist in a five-dimensional world, three dimensions of space, a fourth dimension of time, and a fifth spiritual dimension. Modern science confirms the first four and has no definition of the fifth. This book gives an ancient definition of all the five dimensions, such as a depth of beginning, a depth of hand, a depth of above, a depth of below, a depth of east, a depth of west, a depth of north, a depth of south, a depth of good, a depth of evil. I am Reverend Dr. Goran, the founding father of Kadoshology, from Hebrew Kadosh, holy, to the science of the Bible holiness study, and Peccatology, from Latin Peccatum, the sin, the science of sin study, demonstrate that I have a definition of the fifth dimension. We observe four types of grooves in the figure. 1, 2, 3, 4. Namely, the first one is a rectangle. This one. The second one is a triangular. This one. And the third one is a semi-cylindrical.
this one. And finally, the fourth one is trapezoidal, this one. We see these ferrules on two levels, on the natural level and on the artificial level.
The first example of natural groove is inhibitor of pain. Inhibitor of pains are in the neuron of human being. In the brain of human being, we have inhibitor of pains. We have some examples. The first example of inhibitor of pain here is here. We have what is called receptor. Receptor, a specific receptor here, and here we call here and here. But what is important here is to look carefully to the shape. The shape is triangle. Okay, we are going to see another one where the shape is not triangle. Here, the receptor is semi-cylindrical. The third. Here, the first one, the receptor are triangle. And the neurotransmitter are triangle. Here, down there. Here, the receptor is practically cylindrical, I mean round. Here is semi-cylindrical, the first one as example. We see here that the transmitter, neurotransmitters, are cylindrical and the receptors are semi-cylindrical. The last one. The last one resembles the first one. The receptor is triangle. And the neurotransmitter are triangle. All of them are natural grooves. In the Bible, the book of Genesis 1, verse 12, it is written, the land produced vegetation, plant bearing seed according to their kind, and trees bearing fruit with seed in it according to their kind. And God saw that it was good. Anything God created are declared good. All of that God created, He found them all and declared them good before creating yet others. Plants from the vegetation He created were all declared good without exception. These plants include tobacco leaves used to make cigarettes, and narcotics, heroines, cannabis, Indian hemp, extra, used as drug, and drug derivative. Small-scale drug production is considered as smuggling, while large-scale production for pharmacy medical purposes seem to be permitted. It is for this reason that Colombia preferred to legalize everything throughout its territory, because this same plant, being part of the vegetable creature of God, God declared it good also on the day of creation, provided that this creature is used only responsibly for an hand that God has assigned to it at the dawn of creation according to its properties. In the book of Proverbs, Proverbs 16 verse 4, it is written, "The Lord works out everything for his own hands." When God creates something, he does it for a purpose. Nothing is not created without purpose. Most medicines from pharmacies and used in chemotherapy by surgeons are drugs accompanied by strict medical prescription. These drugs are dosed and used in local and general anesthesia. The international classification of drug departs from the most dangerous to the less dangerous ones, namely heroin in the first dangerous drug, and the second ethyl alcohol in the second drug, and the third one is tobacco. Tobacco is the third drug. The fourth, cocaine. Cocaine is the fourth drug. And the fifth, Indian app. Indian app called cannabis. Indian app, and so on. All these drugs, without exception, create confusion effect once they reach the brain of any consumer. It is this effect who gave the name of some drinks found in a particular rank of the sellers, namely the spirits. After the consumption, they act directly by controlling all your brain through your brain, all your being through your brain. They disrupt your brain and cause you delirium in your behavior. For the addict, they cause him feeling of well-being. Addicts are like angels in the clouds, and they no longer feel any pain. It is this inhibition of pain that the surgeon exploit as a sedative to appease the great pain in severely injured people. Specific brain receptors that are natural growth biochemically receive neurotransmitters in the triangular or semi-cylindrical slots. From then on, the drug addict who lives in the addiction of drug believes himself in the heavens. We also see around us in our artificial environment vinyl compounds that have traditionally been used to make record player of 33 and 45 turns since the 1960s, the 1970s, and the 1980s. The record players are diamond-headed players. We also have a typology of heads: conical, elliptical, linear contact, microline, etc., corresponding to grooves traced on the two blanks of a turntable. In the past, we noticed that the sounds recurring made in the depth and along the furrows of the diamond players had diamond players' head were to come out of the furrows and to deposit elsewhere. The current sound would be cut and give place to another discordant sound. Clearly, the reader has just delirious. I mean, he has gone out of the frame, the Latin called lira. Existence of creatorial law, the laws that the creator made use while creating. The creation of man by God obeys this creatorial law, from Latin creatoralis, which is specific to the creator, of which the creator made use while creating, from Latin creator, creator, which consisted in bringing together scattered or different elements to form an active, conscious, and thinking whole at the same time, namely the prior formation of the biophysiological structure, in which God introduced a breath of life, the spirit, whose intersection with the dust gave rise to an alive soul. Only the body returned to the dust, and spirit to God, who is spirit. The soul, as for it, no longer has existence in itself. It is by abuse of language that one speaks of the salvation of the soul instead of salvation of the spirit. The spirit of man, like those of spiritual beings, thinking creature without body, and therefore without soul from their intercession, is conscious and thinking. The man is therefore a pensient man, from Latin pensare, to will. Figurative is to reflect, to think, from Latin scientis, he who knows, the Latin verb scire, to know. I mean a creature that determines himself to act freely for good or evil after reflection and in full knowledge of the cause. God has engraved in man the faculty of reflecting, of judging, of discerning what is good from what is not. So before doing any act, unlike the animal, man is conscious and is a psychosomatic state to which is added the socio-economical one. Adam. Adam, the first human creator, was conscious of his being. He took care before he went to the same for the animal. Really, God had the will to create his image and not to create sin. The act of creation consisted in bringing together existing materials with different starting properties in a single mold into a whole. The whole property of which differ from that of the part taken individually, that is a whole acting, thinking and being conscious. The creatorial laws which have been used to reach as the final result say that this world will exist and will live as such until it violates the active principles of the law of its own creation. In the book of Ezekiel 20, verse 11, in reading, I gave them my laws and made them know my ordinance, which man must put into practice in order to live by them. For creatures and for the Creator, living by the creatorial laws does not mean that God created sin. So, loving to continue to exist and live by observing the law that make them creatures is first of all to love Him who brought them forth from nothingness to love oneself personally and to love also and equally one's neighbor. Refusing to observe those laws that make them what they are, for creatures made thoughtful, is rejecting he who made them as such, hating oneself, and hating subsequently the other part of oneself, the neighbor. The true sin will begin when the first creatures will violate the principles of those laws on which existence of the thinking creature depends. By refusing to live by them and to attain the objective which their creator had set for himself by creating anyone. At first glance, creatorial law were written nowhere on any given books, Dick, support except in art. It is from Moses that this will be prescribed. From Adam to Moses, sin was there without being well known, because the law that technically revealed its existence were not yet promulgated. In the Bible, in the book of Romans 5, verse 13, it is written, "To be sure, sin was in the world before the law was given, but sin is not charged against anyone account where there is no law." Existence of creatural laws, I mean the laws that creatures made use while existing. In the book of Job 37, verse 7, he put a seal on the hand of men that all may know himself as his creatures. And it is written in the book of Psalm 100, verse 3 to 4. "Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and not we ourselves. Enter his gate with thanksgiving." Recognizing oneself as such, creatures themselves made in the image and likeness of God the Creator, to continue to exist and live well, will conceal their own creatural laws, and the violation of the latter by the creatures themselves will arouse the intervention of God of justice, who recount and avenges them with equity by reminding everyone of the blessing of well-being linked to observance and the curses of ill being attached to violation of his creatorial law, which he has commanded since Moses. In Deuteronomy chapter 27, verse 11 to 30, it is written, "On the same day Moses commanded the people, 'When you have crossed the Jordan, these tribes should stand on Mount Gerizim to bless the people: Simon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, Joseph, and Benjamin. And these tribes should stand on Mount Ebal to pronounce curses: Reuben, Gad, Asher, Zebulun, Dan, Neftali. This recall does not mean that it pleases God to create or institute sin. The context justifying the following verse of Lamentation does not say that God purposely and evidently brought evil, the sin. In Lamentation 3, verse 38, a reading, when one violates human justice in the face of the Most High, when one does wrong to another in his cause, does not the Lord see him? Who will say that a thing happens without the Lord ordaining it? Is it not from the will of the Most High that evils and good come? By prescribing and promulgating the law through Moses, God paradoxically foresaw the blessings, goods, and both curses, evils, that demonstrate his perfect sovereignty and justice in his remuneration with his creatures. It is this paradoxical aspect of the Lord that Jeremiah recalls in Lamentations, but not the proof that God himself created evil and goodness. You are a patient, thinking and conscious creature that has the laws of your creation to observe just to continue to exist or live as created. If, on the other hand, you refuse to do so as planned, the justice that the Creator will pay you according to your way of acting. A reading in the Bible in Exodus 20, verse 12, and Matthew 25, verse 46. Exodus say, "No, let us prevent him from taking the tree of life and living forever." And Matthew say, "But the righteous will go to eternal life." So, his curses will sanction your action of non-compliance with the creator law that regulate your perennialty as a creature. If you do opposite to, you will receive his blessing that will prolong and eternalize your life. In partial conclusion, there is no doubt to recognize existence of creator's law. We creatures have to obey and continue to live. These laws of the Lord, he called them his way or his ways. It's written in Genesis 18, verse 19, "For I have chosen him," Abraham, "so that he will direct his children and his household after him to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is right and just, so that the Lord will bring about for Abraham who has promised him." And it is written in the book of Psalm 103, verse 7, "God made him know his ways to Moses, his deeds to the people of Israel." Through holiness and sin, we are going to see if really thinking creature follow or not the above mentioned way of the Lord that Roman language call lira. Otherwise, if most of them go far away from them, causing the Latin verb delirare to be meaningful in God's law violation, causing delirium or having delirious. Holiness and sin, new approach. It is written in the book of Ezekiel 44:23, The priests are to teach my people the difference between the holy and the common, and show them how to distinguish between the unclean and the clean. Holiness and sin should be separated. This is the will of God. When Christians and pastors talk about sin, it thinks generally of the ordinary ones, such as theft, lie, adultery, worshipping of idols or fetish, extra. Evangelists preaching to touch sinners' hearts so that they may give their lives to the Lord while repenting themselves for their bad way or works, ask to criminal, to murderer, to she or he who does abortion extra to stand up and repent for his crime in view to obtain from God his forgiveness. The topical approach of the sin consisting in listing, enumerating sins topic after topic. The Bible itself shows its limit from the Old to the New Testament as mentioned in the following passages. Exodus 20, verse 17. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife or his manservant or maidservant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. Galatians 5, verse 19-21. Sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissension, faction and envy, drunkenness, orgies and the like. In 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 9-10, reading, we also know that law is made not for the righteous, but for lawbreakers and rebels, the ungodly and sinful, the unholy and irreligious, for those who kill their fathers or mothers, for murderers, adulterers and perverts, for slaves, traitors and liars and perjurers, and for whatever else is contrary to the sound doctrine. Anything that belongs to your neighbor and the like, and for whatever else is contrary to the sound doctrine, proves that topical approach through topic will never permit us to end listing the sin and then finish up knowing one day what the sin is really. It is why peccatology, the general theory of sin, proceed through a systemic approach. It is give the universalizable definition of sin, making use of the infinite set theory. Building a scientific theory means finding the fixed guiding principles and unchanging laws. Therefore, once the law of particular experiences of the sin and the principles of the sins are known, peccatology gives us possibility of retrotelling, telling and foretelling. I mean retrodict, to dict and to predict upon whichever of the pecaminous act. It means that the potential of peccability of a past, present or future sinful act becomes detectable. From this moment, peccatology, the Bible science center on the scene, can demonstrate from now on that our sinners before God, the most perfect democrat, the Masonic, Rosicrucians, spirits, mystics, esoteric, Buddhists, extra, even he who worship Mary, mother of Jesus, a sinner, and so forth. Thus, you'll see the sinner's circle widening because the ordinary sin algorithm is also valid and works wonderfully with the one of the extraordinary invisible sins. In 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 24-25, a reading, the sin of some men are obvious, reaching the place of judgment ahead of them. The sin of the others trail behind them. In the same way, good deeds are obvious, and even those that are not cannot be hidden. systemic approach of sin, inventing new evils within infinite set. With systemic approach, we have, first of all, definition. And secondly, we have to talk about the arborescence, the tree of knowledge. First, definition of system. Systemic word comes from Greek. In Greek, it is said systema. This means assembly, composition. From the particle syn, this means with, together, and stemma. Stemma means crown, guard. It is the science and or technique that studies infinitely complex systems, unlike the traditional and even modern systematic, which deals only with the study of complex system. Indeed, quintidimensional systemics, metasystemics, including the study of all systemic sciences, is quintidimensional systemics, which studies the system of systems. It is from this system that it was concerned when Kenneth Boulding spoke of transcendental system, in which his work hierarchy of systems because transcending all the rest. Also, for the sake of intellectual clarity, we do not keep this name, which will create confusion with the practices of Maharishi Yogi, transcendental meditation, and will risk the profanation of the secret. The transcendental system is the system that transcends all the systems. We prefer to call the quintidimensional system. The quintidimensional system constituting at the same time the system of law, of holiness, and that of sin, called separately the general theory of holiness and sin, kadoshology and peccatology. Secondly, we are talking about the tree of knowledge, the tree that includes at the same time good and evil. We call the arborescence. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Reverend Dr. Nguyen. This morning, I am presenting something I say particularly because in the Bible, Christians are used to approaching the question of sin and holiness with the topical approach. I mean, the approach that enumerates the different kind of sin. So, we have a new approach. The new approach is systemic. We are going to introduce a systemic approach to you this morning. In the Bible, it is said that only the Holy Spirit can separate spirit from soul. So, it is very difficult to split soul from the spirit of a man, of a creature. Okay, but today we are going to try something very difficult. Difficult because we have to separate the Bible tree of knowledge. In Genesis, it is said that God created the hidden garden, and this hidden garden includes two trees, the trees of knowledge and the tree of life. We are going to talk about the tree of knowledge. The tree of knowledge talk particularly about sin and holiness. I mean good and evil. And so, this morning, our presentation, we are going to try to split, I mean to separate this tree, separate good from evil. I mean holiness from sin. We are going to separate
with the Holy Spirit, we succeed separating the tree of knowledge in the Bible. This tree talk about sin and holiness. This is the tree. I split it with the help of Holy Spirit. This is the trunk, the main trunk. And here, the bigger branches. And here are the small branches. Okay. The trunk is the general theory of cardiology. Is the trunk is the main, the general theory. And branches, great branches, are the principle, I mean the guiding principles, all this science. And the guiding principle commands laws. We have about 49 laws. 14 here, 14 here, and 21 laws here. Okay, the law commands fact. You see here, laws are in dark, and in the blue, the green color here are the leaves of the tree. And here, in the color, red color, are the fruit of this tree. And the fruit are the different facts, I mean, the fact. If I have to sum up, trunk is the general theory. Branches, great branches, are the guiding principles. And here's small branches are the laws. And here the leaves. And here the general, I mean the different facts commanded by the law. It's the same for the sin. The same tree is divided in two parts. The first part is for holiness, and the second part talk about sin. And the trunk, the main trunk here, represents the general theory, all the science. I mean the science called peccatology. And the main branches, are the represent, I mean, the guiding principles of the science. And here are the laws. I have 49 laws. 14 laws here. 14 laws here. 21 laws here. The difference is due to the fact that the first one talk about somebody. He himself in his relationship with himself. The second one talk about otherness, the neighbor. Otherness, one in his relationship with the other, the neighbor. And the third one is the creator, God, our relation with God. The different laws that, I mean scientific laws that regulates I mean that rules the relationship with human creatures with God.
Okay, in 1956, Kenneth Boulding wrote in his book Hierarchy of Systems, Hierarchization of Systems, and his hierarchy was written in 9 rank. The first one was canvas 1, second clock, third thermostat, fourth cell, fifth plant, sixth animal, seventh human, eighth social organization, ninth transcendental system. The same Kenneth Boulding in 1985 reorganized the system, and this time he obtained 11 rank. The first one is a mechanical system, the second is a kinematic system, the third is a positive feedback system, the fourth is creatic system, the fifth is reproductive system, the sixth is a demographic system, seventh ecological system, eighth evolutionary system, nine human system, 10 social system, 11 transcendental system. After the work of Kenneth Boulding, I have my contribution. My contribution is simply to maintain his hierarchy from the rank 1 to 11, but to reorganize. The reorganization begins here. A group of systems are organized horizontally, and only a system is vertical. System 1, System 2, System 3, System 4, System 5, System 6, System 7, System 8, System 9. In System 9, we see a human system. In human system, we see here at the point of the power here, we see the man, a man. And this man here, we have 10 men, 50 men, 100 men, extra. My contribution is the reorganization, but the second part of my contribution is the fact that Kenneth Boulding organized from the less to the high system, from the less complex to the high complex system, from the mechanical system to the transcendental system. My contribution is different. My contribution begins from this transcendental system to the less complex system, because my contribution is spiritual. God is holy, and God tried to come near by us, to come to us, and when coming, he comes with his holiness, entire holiness,
and the relationship from God to the man is our the field of our study. God, descending through this cloud column here is vertical, and Moses in the elbow, the shape of elbow, plum elbow, have relationship, vertical relation with God and horizontal relation with the other one. And we are going to see with the following why human being can be complex, more complex than the other one. The first hierarchy of system is the scientific principle of arborescence. This is the work of Kenneth Boulding. From systematic, I mean botany, zoology, systematic, theology, extra, the study of linear and simple system to systemics, I mean cybernetics, electronics, macroelectronics, computer science, discrete mathematics, combinatorial robotics, system dynamics, extra, that of non-linear or random system called multi-complex system. The first principle which characterizes every system and which is known as the arborescence is indeed the arborescence principle. It is at first sight the view of the structure similar to that of a tree, namely the arborescent structure of a world composed of elements. The second hierarchy of systems. This second hierarchy of systems comes from my work. It is a pre-scientific divine principles of arborescence, this GORAN work. The creator of the heavens and the earth to show for the first time what good and evil resemble, as he had assimilated the knowledge to the knowledge of a tree in these terms. Genesis 2:17. But you will not eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. What precedes is what is written in dark and white in the secret text of the Bible as seen and read by Paul. To further argue that any object whose shape resembles a tree so that it can be described as a tree always presupposes the prior existence of the creation of God called tree. The secret code of the Bible revealed that in addition to what is visible, God has encoded 25 tree names under the original Hebrew text of Genesis chapter 2 relating to the Garden of Eden, of which verse 17 makes us read visibly the word tree on the knowledge of good and evil, that precatologists and cardiologists call the cardiological and precatological tree. Here is the excerpt of this encoding mentioned by the secret code. A fascinating element of this phenomenon was detected in Genesis chapter 2, which also deals with the Garden of Eden. Scientists have identified 25 tree names encoding only in the Hebrew text of this chapter.
In a word, before scientists of this world name a system that resembles the tree of the arborescent system and deduce from it an arborescence, God, the creator of the tree, who knew better the mathematical scheme of holiness and sin as object, had already encoded and announced it. We are going to see two hierarchy duos, landmark or vision line. Kenneth Boudin's vision line.
Gentlemen,
and Goran's vision line.
With you tonight.
First of all, we are going to see the first hierarchization of system from Kenneth Boudin. Kenneth Boudin did his hierarchization from the smallest system to the greater system. From the smallest scale to the great scale. This is a gradation going from 1, 2, 3, 4 until 11, a gradation. Okay, from the component of the hierarchy of Kenneth Boudin system, Jeannot Goran will reconsider the entire system by reorganizing the following. One, being assumed to be on the same wavelength because embedded into each other are classified horizontally. Here, we notice that everything is embedded each other. The man is embedded in the chief of 10, embedded in the chief of 50, etc. Why? The other, which makes the transcendental exception, supplanting them all, is held in an upright position vis-à-vis of all of them. Here, this position is vertical in relation to the horizontal position. Social and horizontal are vertical linking in the form of horizontal and vertical elbow. Here we see that,
gentlemen,
the elbow,
it has been a privilege playing with
the
tonight.
Shape of elbow that represent Moses is totally different from this one and the other one. It is horizontal here and a vertical here. This is the particularity of my contribution. In summary, we notice that from the smallest to the greatest scale, hierarchization is did by gradation by Kenneth Boudin. And second, telescoping from the greater scale to the smallest scale, we notice that hierarchization is did by degradation. This shows us the scheme, telescopic scheme here. The second hierarchization of system. This hierarchization of system
come from Goran. It is done by degradation, a telescoping structure. A telescoping structure. Eternal God, the Creator, is holy and demands that those who approach Him also be holy. However, given the distance of His throne and the incommensurability of His limits, it is difficult to evaluate and measure all His holiness characteristics to learn more in order to become holy as He wills. Nevertheless, it must be mentioned that God did not remain at His remote throne to communicate with human beings at a distance. As a spirit, He moved into a pillar. God moved into a pillar.
It has been a privilege
of cloud, a day of fire, a night. This here, this scheme is a night, and came close to us, to the mercy seat within the tent of meeting under the Leviticus priesthood in the time of Moses. Given the lightness of the weight and our mass of the earth compared to those of the one who cannot contain in any container, he approached as following the diagram of a telescopic structure. Here, we notice that the structure is a telescopic structure. This telescoping has retained all its characteristics of holiness in the homothetic figure which emerges from it by speaking of the projection of all His greatness with a smaller scale on a less vast space than the earth. Thus, the mercy seat, whose dimensions are regularly known, welcomes the great spirit who was immeasurable from the throne. This underlying scheme is that by which His holiness was communicated to the sinful man by a gradual de-hierarchization of His divine system of supreme complexity toward the less and less complex system that is a man. Okay, from here, complexity going to the less and less system, less complex system, and here the man.
Gentlemen,
man.
It has been a privilege playing with you tonight.
Passing through the social system from the transcendental system, God passed through the social system before reaching the human system. And the human system. This amounts to reorganizing
the hierarchization of systems, according to Kenneth Boulding, in the biblical context, to better understand what he calls transcendental system. Okay, reorganizing the system of Kenneth Boulding could permit us to understand clearly what Kenneth Boulding called transcendental system. In the context of the Bible, God had come to a column of rescue, which was later to be called Jesus Christ, the Savior or Salvation, under the New Covenant. God came through this column of rescue. Having communicated His Holiness or His Lord of Holiness to Moses, who in a plumbing scheme resembled an elbow. Here the plumbing scheme. Moses is represent this scheme, the elbow in plumbing. Moses, who in a plumbing scheme resembled and the latter was placed over the head of 1,000 and represented the head of vertical, horizontal and social system for having communicated with his sanctity received from the vertical and transcendental system, and this passed it along the horizontal and human system, which the point of four is the unitary signal, the man. Okay. The man is the unitary signal, and through this way, God passes and come to the man. Here, presented by biblical verses, the structural formula of the telescoping that schematizes the biblical holiness. In the Bible, in Exodus 13, 21, 22, it is written, "The Lord went before them in a pillar of cloud to guide them in their way, and in the night in a pillar of fire to light them, that they might walk day and night." The pillar of cloud did not withdraw from the people during the day, nor the pillar of fire during the night. In Exodus 18, verse 90 to 21, "Be the interpreter of the people to God." Here's are the people, and Moses come on behalf of the people to God, and is interpreter of the people before God. "Teach them the ordinances and laws, and let them know the path they must follow and what they must do. Choose among all the people men capable of fearing God men of integrity and enemies of cupidity, established them over them as chiefs of a thousand. Okay, he is the chief of thousand, chief of hundred. He is the chief of hundred, chief of 50. He is the chief of 50, chief of 10. He is the chief of 10, until the unitary senior man. We are going to show human being as the most complex of all complex systems in the known universe. Two ways shows us that human being is very complex. We take the brain of human being. And second, we will talk about the gut. Okay, first of all, I am talking about the brain. Here, you see the complexity of the brain. You see a neuron and synapses and the link, this in the inside the brain. The human brain contains 100 billion nerves, cell called neuron, while the spinal cord contains 100 million. So now, the known universe, human being is the most complex antifairly order of whole complex system. Therefore, human being in the hierarchy of systems of kidney building, while being the simplest unitary element of the human system, however, remains the most complex individual element of all other systems that it has filed before him. I am going to give some more images in the brain. This is the second image of the brain. Third image of the brain, the complexity of the brain. Fourth, showing the complexity of the brain. Fifth, showing again the complexity of the brain. Seventh, showing the complexity of the brain. The last image showing the complexity of the brain. This means that human being's brain is very complex. We are going to show a second image that demonstrates that human being is complex. Human being's gut, the gut is very complex. In the USA, Professor Michael Gerson discovered that the gut of human being contains neuron too. We call it the second brain of human being. Ears are neuron. These where the gut is cut, and ears are neuron. This the link of communication. Okay, this another image of the gut, showing that the gut has neuron too, like the brain. The last image we see here, the different neuron. This brain, the second brain, is called the enteric nervous system. Enteric nervous system. Enteric because this word enteric comes from Greek. In Greek, enteros means gut. Enteros. This part of neuron consists of more than 1 million nerve cells. Or neuron, 1 million. In short,
All the human nervous system consists of a complex system of about 102 billion neurons, totally known until today, that show the complexity of human being. From the first to the fifth dimension. And the last one talked about the different set. First of all, we are going to show the different dimensions. The first dimension is a straight line. Here's the dimension. The first dimension. The second dimension is a Euclidian plane. The mathematician, Greek mathematician called Euclid. Euclid work upon the second dimension, 2D. And after Euclid, Isaac Newton work on the three dimension, 3D. He worked before Benoît MANDELBROT come afterward. And Benoît MANDELBROT came later, but his work was between both of the dimensions, the second and the third dimension. He worked on the fractal dimension. The fractal dimension is a luxury between the second and the third. And the fourth dimension was what is called space-time, or only time. The work of Albert Einstein. Okay, what is particular is the originality of our work. We are working upon a so-called fifth dimension. I say so-called because many of them work to discover it. Many of scientists try to discover the field it's existing, but they could not discover, they could not define this dimension. Okay, this dimension is called SpiriTempuSpace. It is the fifth dimension, the work of Jeannot GORAN. Formerly, a French mathematician called Julia had a set, and with this set, Benoît MANDELBROT tried to make a synthesis of, he synthesized this set, and from the synthesis we obtain today the symbol of fractal geometry that is called the set of Benoît MANDELBROT. And the particularity of my work is that my sets are not coming from anybody elsewhere. I departed from my head, my home set. And afterward, I discovered Benoît MANDELBROT. And from this meeting, I know that Benoît MANDELBROT is dead, but I discovered his word, his work, and from this moment I discovered that I can synthesize my work to obtain a symbol of the quintidimensional symbol of here's the great set of Goran, and I am going to tell you the different compartments that compose this great set, how it is designed, what I did, how I tried to design them. From this one, considered as the symbol of my mathematician scheme, I am going to the different sets that I draw formally and explain some of them so that you may understand the whole. Since 2004, I began drawing my own scheme, and I want to show you here the scheme talking about holiness at the right side, the scheme talking about sin. There are 14. I began by drawing a sin scheme. When somebody is sinning, it draws a kind of scheme, and I received the inspiration from the Lord that when somebody is doing something wrong, there is a kind of scheme that he designed. Okay, I want to show you two simple examples. Here are the examples that I'm going to explain to you. Okay, this scheme is the scheme of a drunkard, somebody who drinks so much. When he drinks so much, and he has to walk, he cannot follow the lira, the Latin say lira. It is this reason why we say in Latin delirare, and delirare, this means that you go out of the lira. Okay. And this small point, dark point, is a man. He's a drunkard. After drinking, his movement changes. He cannot follow here the ways that he has to follow. His movement changes. Here the movement of a sinner, a drunkard. Here, a second simple image. This is a scheme of a backslider at the church. In the church, there are some Christians, some people who become Christian, and they begin doing the deal with the baptism. the life of being Christian, and later on they decide not to continue. They decide to go back. That in the Bible would say the backslide. The backsliders. Here's the movement, the scheme of the movement of a backslider in relation to this lira. This way that God command him to follow, but he backslide. Okay. This is the side of sin side. I show you two examples of scheme, of sinner scheme. Okay, I've show you two examples of sinner scheme. I want to take another example of the holy one here at the right side. At the right side, I prefer to show you simple example. This one is a kind of scale. You see here this dark point, a man, and the man follow away. And if you notice, the way consists in going from the lower steps to the high steps, from the lower step to the high step. Okay. If it is somebody who is lazy, he won't move. He won't move going step by step. I mean going from the lower to the higher step. And that is represented in the sinner's scheme here. This guy is a very lazy, a lazy one. He could not move to go step by step here. But this other one, the holy guy, is going step by step from the lower to the high. Second example here. Here, when the children of Israel departed from Egypt to the promised land, the way they follow is not straight, a straight line like this. The way they follow is a curve, is the way they follow. And we know that they were guided by God himself. But why the way they follow is not straight? The fact that the way is not straight does not mean that God himself is not holy. This is a particular way of God. This particular ways of God should be like that. And here, the one who does not want to follow, he goes straight line to and he go through this a kind of sinner, different from this other one. Okay. To sum up, when you receive different explanation on my different set here, this was my set. I began drawing them a long time before discovering the work of Mandelbrot. The first group of schemes that we've just seen deal with the relation of somebody
with himself. I mean, if this concerns myself, the relation of myself to myself, the first group of things we have just seen. This other one that we are seeing here concerns the relationship between somebody with otherness, I mean with his neighbor. Okay, with his neighbor. I want to show you just some examples, the simplest examples. Look at here. When athletes are racing on the stadium, look at here. Two athletes, small, two dark points. They are racing. When running, they have a strict prescription to follow their way, their lira. They should not delirate. They should not be delirium. They should not go out. They should go straight. If any of them try to leave his way to go there, so this other one is disqualified. Okay, look at here, the scheme of a winner, of a sinner. The scheme of sinner here, this guy, both of them are following their own way. And this guy let his way to go to disturb the other one. And none of them could follow the way that they have to follow. Okay, this the most simple example I can give here as explanation. The other ones, most of them are complicated, so I am going to talk about the third group of schemes to show you a bit how things works. The third and last group of schemes, the third one, are holiness scheme. The other one are sin school. These schemes that I designed express something in the Bible. And when I read the Bible, when I read the verses, and I receive inspiration to design exactly the relevant schemes, the correspondent schemes. Okay, I want to show you an example here, a simple example, so that you may know, you may understand. Okay, this example. In the Bible, Jesus said that nobody can go to God without going through himself. And Jesus said in the book of John that nobody can go to God without being attracted before. God attract him and God tear him and he goes to God through Jesus Christ. The schemes here, like when you see point here, infinitely point here, this means God. And when you see this one, this here,
This means Jesus Christ who comes down for salvation to save people. Okay, look at here. Here we are turning. We are turning this one and turning the sinner here. This is done by God, not somebody else. It is telling him to tear, and he comes. But he goes to God through Jesus Christ, otherwise he cannot be saved. Okay, this is an example of holiness movement. When you see those who are called XXIIths, XXIIths say that you can go to God without Jesus. You can go to God on your own initiative. You know that the principle of this law is violating the principle. So those who behave like that cannot be holy men. Okay, this is the first explanation I can give. Okay, the second explanation of is a simple scheme. Here. Okay, when somebody hear a man small, he follow this way to go to the tabernacle, and the tabernacle here is the first the place, the first place, the second place that is called the holy place, and the third place that is called the holy place. Okay, when somebody comes and he steals something in this place and goes out, you see that he comes with this dimension, and going out, you see that his waist is bigger because he took a chair or a table or he took something, he steals something to go out. Okay, this a kind, a specific sinner, the sinner that Latin call sacrilege, the guy who steals something in the secret place to go out with. Okay, to sum up, I want you to keep in mind that these schemes express the relation of any human creature or any thinking creature with God the Creator. This express this relation. For the scientists, mathematicians, physicists, and the other ones, defining a dimension means find a formula, a general formula that express the whole. But the particularity of Benoît Mandelbrot was that he did not depart his work from formulas. He designed his work begins from schemes, from figures, and from these figures, from this image, is going to find the formula. Okay. Since the day I discovered the work of Benoît MANDELBROT, I said to myself that as I am drawing the tree of knowledge, the tree that contains good and evil, holiness and sin, to draw this tree, I need to take my own sets, my own sets that I draw formerly, and to come and try to design this tree. This is the work I am doing. Okay. And after the final work here, I am going to talk about formula. Because what you are seeing here are the leaves, are the branches of a tree, great branches and small branches and leaves here and fruit. They are the different sets, I call it the different schemes of holiness and sin. This one is totally holiness. I have another one because I split the tree, and this one is totally holiness. And the different set that I use to build my tree of holiness, the part of holiness, does not belong to anybody, as MANDELBROT took the set of Julia to constitute his work. This is the difference between MANDELBROT and my work.